కంట్రోల్ మెకానిజం ఇంట్లో లాస్ట్ క్లాసెస్ వి హావ్ డిస్కస్డ్ అబౌట్ సమ్ ఇంపార్టెంట్ పాయింట్స్ ఇన్ దిస్ చాప్టర్ ఓకే మీన్స్ యాక్టివిటీ అండ్ డిస్కవరీ ఆఫ్ ది ఆక్సిజన్ లైక్ దిస్ వి హావ్ డిస్కస్డ్ సమ్ నెక్స్ట్ let's discuss about the discovery of the first plant hormone that is auxin okay it is on type of phytohormone okay actually auxin is responsible for the bending or auxin is responsible for the phototropism already I told you phototropism means response in plants towards the towards sunlight is called phototropism yes observe carefully this is very important over here response in plants towards the sunlight is called phototropism auxin is the responsible for this phototropism to explain the mechanism of phototropism some scientists conducted number of experiments on this topic first Charles Darwin and Francis Darwin and his son Francis Darwin performed a number of activities on this topic in their experiments they used monocot plants they are small seedling they used seedlings of monocot plant here stem of the monocot plant stem of seedling of monocot plant stem of seedling of monocot plant is called coleoptile monocot plant is called होलियोप्टाइल, ओके इंपॉर्टेंट वर्ड मीन्स लाइक दिस. Like here, this is coleoptile. Now, let us discuss experiment conducted by Charles Darwin and Francis Darwin. Okay, observe. Example observe. First, they covered the, listen carefully, they covered the tip of the coleoptile with a metallic foil, with a metallic or metal foil. Like this, with a metal coil, metal foil. They covered the coleoptile and they exposed the coleoptile to lateral light, like this, to lateral light, they exposed the coleoptile. Okay, this is here light. Okay, now they did not observe the bending, distinct bending in this condition. In this condition. They did not observe the bending. Here bending. Bending. Was not occurred. Bending not occur. Okay, next means they covered only tip of the coleoptile, not entire coleoptile, just a tip. Okay, when they covered the tip of the coleoptile, bending did not occur. Okay, they did not observe the bending. Okay, next, in second experiment, in second experiment, they removed the metal foil from the tip of the coleoptile and they exposed the, like this, they removed and they exposed the coleoptile to lateral light. They exposed the coleoptile to lateral light. Okay, then immediately they observed the distinct bending or the tip of the coleoptile or the tip of the coleoptile. like this, bending occurred at the tip of the coleoptile away from the arc towards the area, towards the region that is opposite to the, or towards the side that is opposite to the lateral light illuminated area. This is the light illuminated side. This is light illuminated side. Now, in their experiment, bending occurred towards the side that is opposite to the light illuminated side. Means away from the light illuminated side. This is the light illuminated side. Okay. Now, bending occurred away from the light illuminated side. Okay. Observe carefully this experiment. Okay, after this experiment, they stated that they concluded that a type of chemical is transported from the tip of the coleoptile to lower region. From the upper region of the coleoptile to the lower region of the coleoptile, one type of electric impulse is transmitted. Because of that chemical or electric impulse, bending can be occurred. That chemical or any other one, something, they stated, something is transported or something is transmitted from the upper region to lower region. Because of that one, bending is occurred. Okay, that is called usually, that transmitted material is called influence. they called usually influence. A type of influence is transmitted from upper region of polyptile to lower region. Because of this influence, bending can be occur. This is a very important statement proposed by two scientists, Charles Darwin. And Francis Darwin. Okay, a type of influence is transmitted is from upper region to lower region. It causes the distinct bending. Observe carefully. They stated that when coleoptile is exposed to lateral light, one-sided light, lateral light, one-sided light, like this, something is transmitted from the upper region to lower region. That causes the distinct bending in that material or coleoptile. This is very important statement proposed by these two scientists. Okay, observe. Next, Charles Darwin and Francis Darwin stated an influence is the responsible for distinct bending, but they did not isolate it. They did not isolate it. After some time, after several years,
Anyway,
They did not isolate that influence. After 3 years, in the year 1926, F.W. Wendt, other scientist Wendt, could isolate that influence from tips of the oleoptiles. Okay, usually, observe carefully, from the tips of oleoptiles of oat plant, coleoptiles of oat plant. This is a very important one here. In his experiment, he used agar block. He used actually agar block, usually agar block, to collect the that chemical or chemical substance. Yes, are understanding? Okay, observe one. Next, let us discuss about the experiment conducted by F.W. Wendt to isolate the chemical substance. Yes, chemical substance means here oxygen. Now observe. This coleoptile seedling of coleoptile. Coleoptile of oat plant. Yes. Next, he removed the tip of the coleoptile. He removed the tip of the coleoptile. He removed the tips of coleoptile and placed the coleoptile tip on agar block or agar fly. These are coleoptile tip. These are coleoptile tip. This is a agar block or agar slice. Okay, now this is the decapitated coleoptile or decapitated coleoptile. Are you understanding? Observe carefully. When he placed coleoptile tip on the agar slice, that chemical substance present in the tips of the coleoptile is transmitted into the agar block or agar fly from the coleoptile tip. That is transmitted into the agar fly. Okay. Observe carefully one. Next. Then he cut these agar slices into small blocks. For example, like this small block. Then He placed the listen carefully here, an agar block on one side of the decapitated coleoptile. Decapitated coleoptile like this. Observe one. Observe carefully. Like this. Next, after some time, he observed distinct bending. Okay, he observed usually distinct bending away from the side where small block of the agar was kept. Okay, like this bending. He observed like this bending. Okay, when he placed the agar block on the decapitated coleoptile, here this agar block contains the substance or influence or chemical substance. That chemical substance is transmitted to one side of the coleoptile. When this chemical substance is transported to one side, on this side, cells are elongated. Cells become elongated. When cells become elongated, what will happen? Distinct bending occurred like this. Eh? Distinct bending occurred like this. Observe carefully. Like this, in this way, when separated or isolated the chemical that is responsible for the bending into the agar slices, then after this experiment, he named the chemical that is responsible for the bending as auxin. Auxin. Understanding? Here auxin means to increase. This is actually chemical substance. Bending can be occurred due to the chemical substance. Here physical substance like electric impulses, they are not involved in this process. Usually chemical substance, that is auxin. Okay, observe one. Observe carefully. In this way, in the year 1926, when separated and isolated the auxin, first phytohormone it is. auxin was isolated by when? Isolated by when? First he took seedling of coleoptile of the whole plant, then he cut the tips of the coleoptile, and he placed the all tips of the coleoptile on the agar slice. Agar slice means it is one type of material. Agar type of carbohydrate, that is solidifying agent. Okay, when we boil and cool it, it becomes solid material. This is a solidifying agent. He places all coleoptile tips on the agar slice. When he places all these on the agar slices, chemical substance which is present in tips of the coleoptile, that is responsible for the bending, that is transmitted into the agar slice. Are you understanding? Then he cut the agar slices into the small blocks. Now these blocks contain the chemical that is responsible for distinct bending. Observe carefully. Okay, now he placed a small block of the agar on one side of the decapitated coleoptile like this. Now what will happen? Then chemical which is present in this agar block, that is transmitted to one side of the coleoptile. Due to presence of this chemical, cells present on this side, they become elongated than the opposite side. In this condition, what will happen? Here, bending occurred away from the side on which agar block was kept, means towards the opposite side of the agar block. Okay, like this, here bending occurred. Entire this process was conducted in dark condition. There is no any light involvement here. There is no light involvement. Here he separated the agar, this chemical or auxin. Okay, then he transmitted the chemical into the one side. Are understanding? For example, when light is exposed from lateral side, for example, in this way, imagine here auxin is accumulated on the opposite side of the light environment or light illumination. Okay, that is why bending occurred towards the light. Understanding? Bending occurred towards the light. Here there is no light involvement. There is no any light involvement. Just he separated and isolated that chemical into the agar glass, and he inserted the chemical into the one side of the folio tie like this. That is why bending occurs. Bending upwards away from the agar block like this. Dirt material was named as auxin. That is the first phytohormone. Here, in Greek language, meaning of the auxin is to increase. So, increase. Okay, observe carefully. This is important experiment conducted by the Wendt in the year 1926. Okay, observe.